Welcome to this demonstration discussing the what and how of the secure function lock feature on a Brother device. The what. Let's look at what the secure function lock looks like on a Brother device. When looking at the device's LCD screen, there are many options that are open to a user. Here, we can see more options open to the user on Basic 2 tab, and also the option to add more functions by pressing the plus icon on the screen. With Secure Function Lock, the administrator can change and lock down certain features and give users home screens limiting the access a user has. The how. Let's look at how the Secure Function Lock feature looks for a user from a Brother device. Once Secure Lock has been activated by the administrator, the LCD will have the following bar at the top left of the screen. Here, we can see the device is in public mode. Public mode will also be set by the administrator, meaning that there is no standard template for public mode. It will depend on the requirements of the user. In public mode, tab 2, we can see there is more options for the user. Once secure function lock has been set by the administrator, the user will need to log in. Select here to see more options, then select Change User. Now the user would select their name. This will be password protected by their administrator. The user will then enter the password, select OK. If the user enters an incorrect password, they will be shown the wrong password screen. They then need to select Close and re-enter the correct password. Once the user has logged in, they will see the options that are available to them, which have been set by their administrator. You can see which user is logged in here. This user only has one tab available to them. They also might find certain icons are unavailable. In this example, if the user selects an icon, they may see the following screen stating access is denied. They then will need to select Close to return to the previous screen. The user may want to use an NFC card to log in, rather than using a PIN each time. They can register a card from the device. If they select the name at the top left corner, the following menu options will be available. They then select Register Card. This screen will now show on the user's LCD, showing them where to touch the card to register. This will depend on the device they are using. Select OK. Now, the user can see that the NFC card has been registered. Then, they select OK again. Now, to authenticate at the device, they just need to tap the card on the card reader. Now the user is logged in to the device. Within the user profile, there may be limited access to certain menu options set by their administrator. If they select all settings, we can see certain options are grayed out within the menu. Scrolling down, we can see more options are grayed out too. This will depend on how the administrator has set the user up and what access rights have been given to the user. If we look at another user here, we can see a different user has logged into this device. They have different options on their screen. They have two tabs available to them. But also, if we look at their login name, we can see a paper symbol with a number at the side here. This means the administrator has limited their print allowance to 5 pages. This number will reduce after each print and reset each day. Finally, the administrator may want all users to log in. This is the public profile we saw at the start of the demonstration. If all users must log in, their device's LCD will be blank as shown here for public mode. They will then either log in with a PIN or tap their registered card on the reader. All these settings are applied by the administrator and can be changed depending on the user's needs and also policies in place. Thank you for watching.